I'm John Cieslake. Currently, I'm the fire chief. Started my career with the Rochester Fire Department on July 1st of 1975.
Brandon Busson, firefighter EMT. I've been on the department for about a year and a half now.
Dave Zaccanini, assistant chief, 16 years of service.
Jim Holcomb, firefighter paramedic. Going on 9 years.
My name is Tom Serwinski. My title is assistant chief, and my date of hire is October of 79.
Bill Beckner, 8 years service.
My name's Paul Simon. I'm a firefighter paramedic. I've been here for about 2.5 years.
Mark Willian, firefighter, over 40 years.
Atherium Bommarito, also known as Bommer here. I'm a firefighter EMT. I've been here just over 2 years now.
All right, Ryan Carey, firefighter EMT, and I've been here for just under 3 years.
My name is Shelby Parks. I'm an EMT, and I'm going to the fire academy right now.
My name is Mark Guerra, firefighter EMT, been here for over 5 years.
My name is Adam Simon. I'm a firefighter paramedic here. I've been here for about 3 years.
Name's Jeff Osling, sergeant paramedic. Been a firefighter for going on 27 years. Been with the department since September of 09.
Gary Vanlo, years of service is just over 8 years.
My name is Robert Tyrell, a member of the Rochester Fire Department Incorporated. Been a member since 1961. 57 years come August this year.
It's a family business for me. My mom and dad were both firefighters. My dad retired from Shelby Township as battalion chief, and my mom's dad and grandpa and a whole bunch of her side of her family is a bunch of firefighters.
I kind of got shoehorned into it. The person I was working for was Rewald Electric, and he was on the fire department at the time. So I got stuck coming to fire calls with him because I worked for him. So then this Chief Lyle Buchanan came out one day and gave me an application, and the next thing I know, here I am.
I've always wanted to do a job helping people, and after seeing my uncle, who was the captain for the Lansing Fire Department, after going to his funeral, seeing the camaraderie and the loyalty that those guys showed, I really thought I wanted to be a part of that brotherhood. So that's what initially jump-started me taking the Fire Academy.
Wanted to give back to the community that I worked in for basically my whole life. My father was retired from the fire department, and at the time, my brother was also on the department.
It was something I always loved as a kid, and kind of got away from it as I got older, and then somehow just got back into it, and absolutely love doing it now.
Feels good to help people, you know.
I always wanted to do this job since I was a little kid. Even more after I got out of high school. Happened right around 9/11, so that made the inspiration even more.
I've wanted to do it since I was probably 4 years old when the TV show Emergency came out.
What I wanted to go ahead and do was to go ahead and find a good way to serve the community. I had an interest in the fire protection from talking to a few of the firefighters who were here in Rochester at the time, mainly Mike Bartholomew.
My next door neighbor begged and begged me to join the fire department.
My first call was a PI over in another city where the car actually split in half.
The first call was a three-car PI to Quinder and Runyon. And it took us a while to get that guy out of that car. We had a helicopter. That was crazy.
Probably my first house fire, because I can still remember it like it was yesterday. So fire in a two-story old Victorian, very large house, well involved on arrival.
First night I got sworn on, we had a house fire up on Hardy Road. And that was a house fire, pretty good burner. All the fires we had back then were really decent fires because of the old construction.
I'd say my most memorable call would be probably my first CPR I had. I was in the middle of a blizzard. We only had three people and we did a phenomenal job, but it's definitely high energy situation, and I'll never forget it, that's for sure.
Oh, it was a barn fire out in Oakland Township.
Well, the first real big fire in our city was the Terry Street fire, and that was pretty, I don't want to say it was cool, but it was a little more chaotic. But it was experience, it was life learning.
Well, the first real fire call was Oak Street fire.
My first real fire would definitely be Oak Street.
The Oak Street fire.
First fire was Oak Street.
Probably the Oak Street fire.
And that was one of the biggest fires I've seen so far.
The biggest fire we've been on here in the city.
Showed up and there was literally flames coming off the roof.
One of the first that I think a lot of the people here have. And it was great seeing everyone work together and really put all that training to work.
That's one of those situations where the tone goes out and all the small things you thought were important that day didn't seem very important. And you gotta work and structure fire with possible people trapped. It's time to shut up and go to work.
All units stand by for a fire pit. Attention Rochester fire personnel, response code 1. House on fire, structure fire confirmed. Smoke is showing, unknown if anyone is still inside.
Dispatch, chief points in route.
Chief points in route. Copy, someone inside. Someone inside.
Dispatch, strike the box on this call. I have a working structure fire, 2-story, 50% involvement.
Copy, strike the box.
Yes, ma'am. We have potential people trapped on the first floor. Unknown at this time.
Fighting a fire at a home in Rochester. Now this happened at a large two-story home on Springview Drive. It all started in the garage and then quickly spread into the attic. Firefighters had to pull back for a while when things got too dangerous.
The local bar takes a big hit after a car barrels into the building. Happened around 1 this afternoon on Main Street in downtown Rochester.
Pets are safe, children are safe. As far as we know, everyone got out of the building safely here.
This accident shut down the intersection of Hamlin and Rochester Roads in Rochester Hills. At least 6 cars were involved.
favorite part of the job is definitely that we're a big family here, and it's definitely a second family for me, which is great. It's definitely a brotherhood, and it's nice having all these brothers and sisters around me, and know they all are back at all times or whatever you need, so it's good. Worst part of the job is that we encounter some things that we can't necessarily fix, whether it's saving someone's life or not being able to save someone's property, and that sucks sometimes because we work our hardest and go through a lot of training, and sometimes it's just not good enough. So,
yeah. It's taught me a lot. It's matured me a lot. It's woke me up to what really could happen to real life scenarios, because we get stuck in them sometimes. And then you go back and think about it, and you do, man, I did stupid things like that. So, it's a maturing opportunity.
Well, my favorite is just the relationship that I have with the guys and girls in this department. We really are a big family, and, you know, beyond all the little arguments we may get in the drama, we all do care for each other, and we would bend over backwards, and ultimately, we would die for each other if it came down to it.
Favorite part of the job is obviously I love riding on the fire trucks. It's an adrenaline rush. And my least favorite part of the job, probably getting up in the middle of the night.
Definitely the people that work here make up the department. There's a lot of camaraderie here, a lot of good bonds, and work with some very, very good people I wouldn't trade for anything.
Favorite thing about this job is all the interesting people I get to work with, and being able to have the opportunity to attend some trainings and go to a fire academy. It's really a great opportunity.
The people.
There's a lot of good people working down here, and we all try to work together to get the job done.
I've seen this department actually grow up quite a bit, and I'm very impressed with the way everything's going right now. So it's obviously on the up and up, so let's just keep doing what we're doing and make good things happen.
It's that concept of people helping each other in a time of need, and to go ahead and help make a difference for each other. I think that's one of the things that I've enjoyed the most, and I'm most proud of here.
My experience here has been fantastic. Like I said, it's been 8 years. It's been 8 great years. I've learned so much. Been a part of a great crew, a great family. I love everything about it. Everything about it.
You know, right now, I could go today if I wanted to. I could retire and just walk away. But years ago, I swore on an oath to serve my community. I like my community. I live here in my community. And I would like to keep serving as long as I'm healthy and able to do so.